Hi everyone, this is Professor Anil Joshi. Today I am going to explain to you the difference between marginal costing and absorption costing. Now in our academics, we all learn and understand what is marginal costing, what is absorption costing, how do you calculate the contribution, how do you do the contribution analysis, so on so forth. So in theory we know all these things. But in reality, what happens when we follow marginal costing versus what happens when we follow absorption costing, that big picture gets lost while we are studying, unfortunately. So today I'm going to explain to you, how in reality, the marginal costing technique or the absorption costing technique impacts the profitability of the organization, so that you will understand the relevance of that technique. So let me take you through the Excel example which I want to present to you. Okay, so let us assume that this is X Limited and this is Y Limited, and X Limited is following say marginal costing and Y Limited is following absorption costing. Now you will notice that the revenue of both the companies, the expenses incurred for production, that is material consumption, wages and other manufacturing expenses, all are same. Now the only difference is that this company is following marginal costing and this company is following absorption costing. Even the units produced, units sold, and obviously if 100,000 units are produced and 900 units are sold, assuming there is no opening stock, then the closing stock will be 100. So everything is same. Correct? All numbers are exactly same between both the companies. The only difference is this company is following marginal costing, this company is following absorption costing. Now let us see how the profitability will be calculated. So marginal costing, what will happen? So marginal costing, that is X Limited. How will you calculate the profit of this organization? Now when you follow marginal costing, you only load variable costs in the cost of the product. So what will be the variable cost? Only these, material consumption is a variable cost, wages are variable cost, because these two are part of your direct cost, prime cost, which are usually variable. And the only variable manufacturing expenses will be loaded in the cost of the product. Fixed cost will not be loaded, right? That will be considered separately in the costing P&L. So your cost of production is going to be 2,54,500. How many units are produced? 1,000. So obviously this divided by this will give you the cost per unit. So let us put that in decimals. What is the revenue of this company? 3,78,450. Now, the cost of production is 2,54,500, but in order to calculate the profit, we need to arrive at cost of sales, right? So 2,54,500 is the cost of production, which is only including variable cost, right? Fixed cost is not included in this. Now, from cost of production, you will reduce the value of the closing stock in order to get the cost of goods sold or cost of sales. Here, I am not considering the selling expenses. So if you reduce the value of closing stock, you will get the cost of sales. Now what will be the value of closing stock? The value per unit we just now calculated, 254 rupees 50 paisa, and 100 units are closing stock. So 254.50 into 100 will give you the value of the closing stock. So cost of production minus this will give you the cost of sales. So now revenue versus the cost of sales will give you the margin or the profit for this particular product. But this is not the profit for the whole organization, because fixed cost you have not yet considered. Obviously that also will have to be considered while calculating the profit. So from this margin or profit of the product, you will reduce the fixed cost, which earlier you had not considered, because this fixed cost is going to be directly considered in costing P&L. So fixed cost in marginal costing is considered as a period cost. So entire 20,000 will be charged directly to that particular period. So therefore the profit of the company will be this minus this, which is 1,29,400. Now let us come to absorption costing, which is followed by Y Limited in our example. Again, the cost of production now will be how much? In absorption costing, you load variable as well as fixed, both types of costs in the cost of the product. That is why it is called absorption costing. You absorb everything in the cost of the product. So now your cost of production is everything including the fixed cost, which earlier we had not considered, right? So including 20,000. So your cost of production is 274,500. How many units are produced? Again, same 1,000. So your cost of product, cost of production per unit will be this divided by this, that is 274.50. Now revenue is same, 378,450. Now cost of production is 274,500. Again, minus closing stock. Now what is the closing stock? 274.50 rupees, which is your cost per unit, multiplied by 100 units in the closing stock. So your cost of production is 27,450. So this minus this will give you the cost of sales. So cost of sales versus revenue, you will get profit. Correct? Now fixed cost is not going to be reduced because you have already considered fixed cost here. So it is already factored in the cost of the production itself. So again, you are not going to consider fixed cost, otherwise it will be duplication. Right? So this is the profit of the product and this is the profit of the company. So now you notice there is a difference in the profitability, right? Everything was same. The only difference was this was marginal costing technique, this was absorption costing technique. Now you will understand that, you know, merely following a different technique, how does it impact your profitability? Now, why it happened? Because in absorption costing, you have considered fixed cost also in the cost of the product, because of which your stock valuation is always higher. See this, 27,450 versus 25,450. What's the difference? 2000 rupees difference. And you will notice that in the profit also, there is exactly 2000 rupees difference. Remember that trading account. In trading account, if your closing stock value is higher, obviously your profit will be higher, na? So here your closing stock is higher by 2000. That is why your profit is higher by 2000. So this is how it impacts the profitability. Marginal costing, all fixed costs are considered directly in that particular period itself. Whereas in absorption costing, you know, even the fixed cost also is loaded in the cost of the production, because of which what will happen is, obviously your stock value will become higher. And in this particular example, you know, because your stock value is higher, basically what happens is that you carry forward higher cost to the next period. So if you are carrying forward 27,450 to the next period, when you say closing stock, it means what? Closing stock becomes opening stock in the next period. So in short, you are carrying forward 27,450 rupees to the next period. So you are not considering 27,450 expenses in the current period. So here in absorption costing, you are carrying forward 2000 rupees more to the next period. So obviously the expenses in the current period will be lesser by 2000. And therefore, your profit will be higher. Alright, so this is what happens because of the different technique followed. Now, unfortunately, this kind of explanation usually is not shown anywhere. And that is why, you know, students don't understand, you know, how it will impact the profitability of the organization. So that is what I wanted to explain to you. Now, had there been opening stock instead of closing stock, the picture would have been completely different. And in fact, it would have been exactly opposite. Because then in that case, in absorption costing, your opening stock value will be higher. And if opening stock value is higher, obviously the profit in absorption costing will be lesser. So whether it is opening stock or closing stock, what you need to remember is in absorption costing, your stock value is higher. Why? Because it includes your fixed cost also. And if stock value is higher, obviously your cost of sales is going to be different as compared to the cost of sales in marginal costing. And that is why your profitability is different. Alright, so I hope you like this video. You know, I have already uploaded many videos on my channel, YouTube channel, to explain the fundamentals or the concepts, keeping in mind the reality. So I have tried to link the academics with, you know, what happens on the ground. So if you like this video, if you have liked my other videos on the YouTube channel, then please, please keep watching my videos. It will be really good if you can subscribe to my channel so that you will get notifications as and when I upload new videos on my channel. Thank you so much. Once again, this is Professor Anil Joshi. Bye for now.